No one likes talking about their business, so let me do it for you with a review of our bidet. We got this last year and we've actually really enjoyed having it. So I'm going to walk through the things that I like, some things I don't like, and everything in between. First off, what you're going to want to know is that you will need an outlet near the toilet to plug in the bidet so it actually works. On the other side, the water connects to the toilet just like so, and you'll notice the bidet seat sits up just over the toilet seat. So ours comes in a little crooked against the toilet seat. Took a minute to get used to, but overall hasn't been a huge issue. Here's the lid. Closes like a normal toilet seat, and it actually kind of blends in with our toilet fairly well. You'll notice the red light to indicate that the power is on and ready to use. So when it comes time to use the washroom, I am not going to demonstrate this for you, but what I will show you are the key functions and how to use it. So it comes with this remote. There are also other controls on the side of the bidet that you can use as well. I honestly forget they're there because I just prefer using the remote. It's easier. And we have it connected to our wall like so with this holder. To use, you're going to select posterior or feminine rhythm for whatever wash you need. As a woman, I really do appreciate this feminine wash. I think it just helps keep everything clean for me, and I feel nice and fresh coming out of the bathroom. Just to add on to that, I will say sit as far back along the bidet as possible so that way you can get the most efficient wash. And then what you can do is adjust the water pressure depending on how hard or fast you need the water to spray. And then there's also a nozzle position, just kind of depending on how you sit on the toilet. So you're going to want to use these buttons to adjust. Another tip to keep in mind, you're going to want to keep your legs closed as the water is springing up so it minimizes any splashing coming out of the toilet. There's this dry button, so when the wash cycle is done, it takes 30 seconds to a minute or so, then you'll hit dry. I do like using this, however, sometimes I do resort to using tissue paper because I always feel like I'm in a rush, and sometimes it's easier to just dry with that. On cold days, this seat temperature is nice, so you can turn up the heat so when you sit on the bidet, it's nice and warm. The water temperature is also nice to adjust, again, to your preferences, same with the dry temp. There is a turbo wash option. I personally haven't tried this yet. I feel like the water pressure works quite well for me. This UV light, if I press it here, it's kind of hard to see, but there is a little light in there just to help sterilize things a little more. Then finally, nozzle cleaning. So I will press this so that way you can see what that nozzle looks like. Sometimes I use a Clorox wipe to just wipe around it, but I think the best thing to use is an old toothbrush to really clean out those crevices where the water sprays out. When you're done with the nozzle cleaning, you'll just press the button again and it goes right back in. And you'll notice it sprays out a little bit of water just to kind of do a final rinse. The other reason I show that too is because that's exactly what happens when you're done using the bidet. Another thing I want to mention, as soon as you sit on the bidet, it will automatically turn on fans just to kind of help circulation and help with a little bit of the smell. And that way it gets everything prepped. So as soon as you're ready for the wash, then select which one you need and you're good to go. Overall, we've really enjoyed having this. The one downside for me is sometimes it can take a while to go use the washroom and then wait for the clean cycle, but I guess that's not the end of the world if you're getting a good wash. So depending on what your lifestyle is and what you need, I think this is a great option for any household. Hope it helps you out, and thanks for watching.